In the last class, we had dealt with how to obtain a grain design for a given thrust time curve, right? And towards the end of the last class, we kind of found out what is it that is required of a grain design. That is, what are the desired features we discussed this, that for a solid propellant system to be very good, you need to have as high a loading as possible, because then you are letting the you are making an optimal use of the given volume, right. So first is high propellant loading. Then we realize that it is better to have neutral burning, right. If you have neutral burning, then your structural utilization is much better. So for better structural utilization, then lastly it should have low sliver loss. In addition to meeting the thrust time curve, okay. If there are 3 or 4 designs that meet the thrust time curve, then we should look at one which has a high propellant loading, and then near neutral burning and low sliver loss, okay. There is a flip side to high propellant loading, namely erosive burning, which we will discuss in the future classes, okay. We will come to that a little later. Now if you remember in the last class, if you look at this figure here, we had designed the grain in terms of y, or the extent of the propellant burnt. And if you look at this graph, then from this graph you can get for any given y the burning perimeter, and from the burning perimeter you can calculate the burning surface area AB, right. So in a sense we had got what we had got at the end of the last class was how to get burning surface area AB to meet our requirements. Now how do we cross check whether what we have designed is going to give us what we wanted in the first place, right. We have to cross check our design. So to do that, let's say we were given a pressure versus time curve like this. Right? If we were given a pressure versus time curve like this, now having gone through the grain design, how do we know that we have been able to get as close to this as possible? All the information that we know is, we know how the burning surface area evolves, right, as some extent of web burnt. We know y versus AB, right, from the graph. Now we also know that from equilibrium relations, equilibrium pressure PC is equal to rho P AB by AT (1−N). So if we know AB, right, we can calculate what is PC, right. The other terms are fixed: AT, density of the propellant, A and C star and N. All these are fixed. So we will get to know what is the chamber pressure variation with AB. So we know Y versus AB. From there we can get Y versus PC. So knowing Y versus AB, we get Y versus PC, but we are still not there because we need Y versus PC versus T, right. This is what we want. So how do we get that? Very simple. We know burn rate, right. Burn rate we know is nothing but dy by dt is nothing but burn rate, right. So this is nothing but APC to the power of n. So using this I can integrate for y and then get, or integrate this equation and get time. So you can rewrite this as t is equal to 0 to y dz APC to the power of n. So we now know time, we now know PC, so we can get PC versus time. So from this we can get PC versus time. So after this we can evaluate whether the design that we have proposed is going to agree with what was given to us, what was desired of us, right. You might not be able to meet it precisely at all the locations, but in an overall sense if you are going to meet it, that is good enough, okay. So there is one doubt still, that is some time back somebody had posed this: aren't we using equilibrium pressure here, this relationship, right. But if you look at this portion, right, this portion is not constant pressure. Are we right in using this equation even to get something for this portion, right. This is changing with time, this is not a constant pressure. So let us see how to find out that, okay. Before we do that we have to derive the unsteady equation. So let us go back to a few classes back wherein we had this control volume of the rocket motor. we have a rocket motor like this, then we know that there is mass coming in because of the burning of the propellant, right? No, it's a z is a dummy variable. That's all. If you have y, you'll integrate it, and it has no meaning here. This is a dummy variable. So here, it is burning in this direction. So this is adding mass, and the mass is going out through the throat. So if we write the unsteady equation, right? Then the accumulation of mass with time must be equal to mass flow in minus mass flow out, right. Now how do we express equation for this? Accumulation of mass with time, this is nothing but m dm by dt. Mass flow rate in m dot in minus m dot out. M dot in and m dot out, we had learned what they are. This is rho p a b r dot minus PCAT by C star. R dot, I can write it as A PC to the power of n. So I'll get rho P AB A C star. Now what is this m? M is nothing but density into volume, right? So we can write rho c is nothing but density of gas and v c is the chamber volume. Now we can write d rho c by rho c v c by dt as equal to rho c into d v c by dt plus V c into d rho c by d t by chain rule, right. What is d V c by d t? If we come over here and look at this finger, how is the V c increasing? A B into R dot is what is giving the increase in the chamber volume, right. So d V c by d t I can write it as A B into R dot. So I write this as R dot, I can write it as A P c to the power of n. Now if I substitute this back in this equation, I can rewrite that equation as V c d rho c by d t is equal to, this goes to the other side, rho p minus rho c Now before we go further, let us get an estimate of what is rho p and what is rho c. Rho p is density of the propellant, right. Depending on the kind of propellant, it varies between 1600 to 1800. What about rho c? How do you calculate gas density? Pc upon RTC. So what typical chamber pressures can go up to 100, okay, and chamber temperatures of the order of 3000. So Pc around 100 atmospheres, then Tc around 3000 Kelvin, molecular weight around 26. So you will get typically rho variation for this case would be around 12.5. Rho c, that is, and typically depending on this pressure, if the pressure is higher you are going to get a higher density, and if the temperatures are higher you are going to get a lower density, and pressure lower also you are going to get. So typical variation of rho c is from somewhere between 8 to 15 kg per meter cube. Compare this with rho p, it is somewhere around less than 100th, right. So if you neglect this term, what is the error that you are going to make? Less than 1%, right. So from an engineering perspective it makes sense to neglect this term, okay. So this rho c, we can write it as Pc by RTc, right. So here if we make the assumption that assuming the gases to be following the perfect gas law, which we have already used, and also making the assumption that Tc and C star are constant. Okay, which is a valid assumption in a sense, even if pressure varies quite a bit beyond some level, Tc and C star do not change by a large magnitude. Okay, they do change, but by not by a large magnitude. So if you make this assumption, then we can write rho c is nothing but Pc by RTc. So if you include in that, you will get Vc. These two, one is a gas constant, the other one we have assumed for the for this case to be a constant. Okay, so then I can take out Vc by RTc, and I'll get dPc by dt. Is equal to rho p a b a p c to the power of n . Now we also know that c star, what is c star? C star is nothing but 1 by gamma of gamma RTc, right? Or if you are going to use the universal gas constant, Ru Tc by molecular weight. So RTc that I have here, I can replace it with C star into gamma of gamma. There is a reason for doing that, we will see that in a little time. Vc by I can take this to the other side, right, and rewrite this expression as where is it? Huh? Oh, VC, sorry. fine. Between these two, right, I can, what is rho p AB AC star? If I divide this by AT and multiply this term by C star, what do I get? This entire term rho p AB A C star by AT. What is this? This is PC to the power of 1 by n, right. So, now I can do that here. There is a C star by AT that I can take out and rewrite this expression as follows. So if I take out AT by C star, right, this term will be PC. This PC is nothing but PC equilibrium pressure, right, PC equilibrium to the power of 1 minus n. So I will get there was a reason for doing this, which you will notice in a short time. What is the unit of this? This is pressure, right, and the left hand side is pressure by time. So in some sense this is 1 by time, right. So let us look at how this is 1 by time. We will call VC by AT, right. VC by AT is chamber volume by throat area. We will call that a quantity named as L star, okay. Huh? Ah, sorry. So if we call VC by AT as L star, okay, this is the ln scale, okay. If you look at this, this has meter cube and meter square. So this is a ln scale. This is the characteristic ln scale of the motor. Now if you divide length by velocity, what do you get? Time. So L star by C star gamma square is nothing but TC, or the characteristic time scale. This is also known as the residence time. this gives us an idea about what is the time that the gases are going to be there in the chamber, okay. And L star, as I said, is a length scale. L star assumes importance in all the three rocket motors that we are going to decide, even in liquids and in hybrids. And this is related to, there is an instability called as L star instability also. Now if you look at this time, characteristic time, if you have a short motor, right, if you have a small motor, this should be smaller, and if you have a large motor, this should be larger. So typical variation of TC is, it is around 1.5 to 2 milliseconds for small motors, and 20 to 40 milliseconds for large motors. This has a implication on what is known as combustion efficiency, that is how much of the combustion is being completed inside the rocket motor. Also depends on the residence time, right. If the residence time is very small, then you would expect, if the reactions take a little longer, those would not be completed, right. So the slowest process in solid propellant combustion is aluminum oxidation. Okay, and that takes something like 5 to 20 milliseconds. So if you have a very small motor, then probably your combustion efficiencies are not going to be very high, okay. Whereas if you have a large motor, your combustion efficiencies are going to be very high, because there is ample residence time to complete the reactions, okay. So typical combustion efficiencies for large motors would be of the order of 99%. So most of the reactions are complete before they go out of the throat. Now coming back to the question that we had in our mind, right, that is when we were trying to look at PC versus T variation for a given grain design, we had assumed that it is equilibrium pressure relations we had used. Is that valid, is what we asked ourselves, right. So let us look at whether that is so or not. So to do that, we will take this equation here, okay. When we take this equation, and how do we decide whether this term is large or small? One way to look at it is, if these two terms are nearly the same, then this term would be small, right. So one way to get a good estimate is to divide this term by one of these two and find out if the fraction is large or small. If it is very small, then the error that we are going to make by neglecting it is going to be small too. So let us take the term Vc by RTc dPc by dt is equal to rho p . Now we will only need to consider the left hand side of the equation, okay. As I said, we will divide the left hand side of the equation by this term, okay. What happens to the right hand side of the equation is not our concern right now. We are trying to estimate this term in reference to one of the terms here, right. So I will take the let me call this term as RLR, okay. So now what is dPc by dt? I can rewrite this as dPc by dy into dy by dt, right. And dy by dt we know is nothing but r dot. So we will get this is equal to r dot into dpc by dy. So if you substitute this back into this equation, you will get r dot vc by RTc RLR is equal to into so I can take out this R dot sorry thank you Now I need to get a relationship for dPc by dy, right. Let us use the equilibrium relation. We know that Pc is equal to rho p ab by at a right. If you take the logarithm of this, you will get log Pc is equal to 1 minus 1 by 1 minus n we know that AB is a function of y right. So differentiating both sides with respect to y we get 1 by one minus n into dAB by AB
sorry, AB dy. Okay.
So, or in other words, I can get the expression for dPc by dy from this, right? And which is
as follows. PC by AB
So if I substitute this back in the equation here, right, dAB by dy, then I'll get RLR would be VC by RTC to PC there is an AB here, so I'll get AB square one minus n . We still need to know how the burning surface area varies with y.
Let's take a progressive burning grain, that is, let's take a cylindrical grain burning from inside to the outside. Okay,
so if you take a cylindrical grain burning from inside to the outside, so at any given let me call this small distance as y, so at any given instant y, if dp is the port diameter, right, so the burning surface area . This is nothing but for any instantaneous burning surface area, you need to add 2y. The diameter is dp plus 2y. So the burning surface area would be pi dp plus 2y into l, the length of the grain into the board. And AB at y equal to 0 would be
okay,
and therefore you can calculate dAB by dy for this. What will it be? 2 pi l, right? Take the derivative of this, you will get okay. So let us substitute that back into the equation that we have here. This equation again we can simplify it further. Let us see how to do it and substitute it back into that.
we know here Pc by RTC is nothing but density, right. So I can rewrite this as RLR is equal to rho C Vc divided by rho P AB square into 1 minus n into DAB by DY, and a DAB by DY we know is nothing but 2 pi L. VC rho C remains the same. VC is nothing but what is the chamber volume? It is the burning surface area into the length. So AB at 0, that is pi DL pi DP square by 4, this burning surface this port area into the length is the volume, and DAB by this is 2 pi L, rho P remains as is, AB square, sorry this is pi DP okay. So we can cancel out DP square here. L square and L square here, right. So after cancelling out and you have pi square and pi square again here. So you have 2 and 4, so you will have 1 by 2. So you will get 1 by 2 1 minus n rho C by rho P okay. We had calculated what is rho C in term and rho P, right. We had seen that a little earlier, that rho C varies from 8 to 15 kg per meter cube, whereas rho P is around 1600 to 1800 kg per meter cube. Now if you take n, even if you take a large n, let us say of n of 0.7. What you will get is RLR will vary from 0.01 to 1.5 okay. So what it tells us is even if the port is burning in a progressive manner or in any other manner, even if you take equilibrium relations there, you are not making a very significant error, primarily because of the density difference between the gas and the solid being of the order of around more than 100, right. And that is the reason why you can afford to take a steady case also, and you will get a very accurate result okay. Thank you, we will stop here, we will continue in the next class.